Welcome to a video on how to create folders in your OneDrive for all of your courses in the beginning of the school year. Or if you're switching courses in the middle of your year, how to create a folder at any point that you need. First, go to the Calvert County Public Schools website, then select the Students tab at the top of the website. Below the Students tab, you'll see student information. Below that, you'll see online tools. Scroll down to Office 365 and click Office 365. It will open up a new tab with all of the Microsoft Office products available to you that Calvert County Public Schools provides. You have an app launcher in the top left corner of your screen that allows you to access any of those apps. You'll click the app launcher and you'll select OneDrive. It will open up to your most recent files that you've been working on in Calvert County Public Schools. But what you want to do is go to the My Files tab on the left sidebar and select My Files. This has all of your folders and files that you've ever created. What you will do is you will create a new folder by selecting New, Folder, and then naming this folder for the current school year. Click Create, and now you have created a folder for the current school year. It will be at the top of your list of folders and files, or if it's not, select Modified, select Newer to Older, and it will then come to the top of your list of folders. Click on that folder for 2022-23, or whatever school year you're in. You have no files in it because you've just created that folder. So you're going to create folders for all your courses by selecting New, selecting Folder, and naming each of your courses for that folder. Click Create, and then keep doing this one step at a time, just naming each folder for that course. So you have courses in your folders for the 2022-23 school year or whatever school year that you are currently in. Click Create, and you'll continue doing so for all of your courses. Don't forget to also do this for your related arts and your elective courses, so you have a folder inside of that school year's folder for all of your courses for that year. So if you go back to My Files, you'll notice the 2022-23 school year folder, if you click it, has folders for all of your courses. The reason this is helpful is because whenever you are naming your files and saving your files, you want to know exactly where you're saving your files and what folder that you can find it later. So let's demonstrate. So we'll go back to the app launcher, we'll open up Microsoft Word. Now we're in Microsoft Word online, but still you can create a blank document. So we're going to create a blank document that you can see right here is named Document 1. So what you want to do first before you even modify that document is name it. So you click on where it says Document 1, and you're going to change the name. So we're going to call this document Social Studies Notes, and maybe even give it a more specific name, which is the name of the student. My last name is Paige. But you also want to make sure that you're saving this document in a specific spot. Right now, just in my name for OneDrive and the Documents folder. I want to be more specific. I want to put it in my Social Studies folder I just created. So you click this arrow to the right, and it's going to pop up with all of your folders and files. You're going to select 2022-23. This is Notes for Social Studies, so we're going to select the Social Studies folder, and we're going to select Move Here. So now what we've just done is, even though we have a new blank document that we opened up in Microsoft Word Online, we've now renamed it right up here. And you can always click on the name of the folder and it'll pop up with where that name of the folder, name of the file rather, is located, what folder it's in, and it's in the Social Studies folder that we just created in our OneDrive. So if you want to see if that worked, all we have to do is go back to My Files. We can go to the 2022-23 folder, click on Social Studies, and there it is. The file that we just named. We can also do this with offline files that we have in Microsoft Office as well. So I have Microsoft Word on my taskbar. I'm going to open up Microsoft Word. I'm going to create a brand new document. So I'm going to click blank document. And what I'll do here is I'll go to File. I'll go to Save As. I'll go to my OneDrive because I'm going to save it in my OneDrive. But I'm going to find the folder we just created, which is 2022-23. And inside of that, this time I'm going to make a science notes file. So I'm going to click on science. And now when I name this file right here, I'm going to call it science notes. And I'm going to click save. I know it's in my 2023 folder and my science folder. And I'll click save right here. And what I've just done is I've named this document, even before I've modified it or added anything to it, with science notes. If I click on science notes right here, it'll tell me it's in my science folder. If we want to see if that worked, we can just go back to our OneDrive and we can go to 2022-23, click on Science, and there we have that file. This is really useful for you. Anytime you download a file from Schoology and you're going to work on it and you're going to upload it back into Schoology to turn it into your teacher, before you edit that file, you should rename it and you should put it inside of the folders that you've created for the course that that file came from. This will be helpful for you to keep your OneDrive organized and keep all of your items in your OneDrive accessible to you so you don't have to hunt for them in different folders, not knowing exactly where you saved it. Hope this was helpful. If you have any other questions, please reach out to the Office of Digital Learning members to help you with setting up your OneDrive.